Buen dia from Tijuana. We are here in the city today to do a food tour and try out some new restaurants. The first of which is La Casa del Mole Poblano.
Yes, I am so excited to do a lot of eating of Mexican food today because a lot of people don't know, but Tijuana has a really great thriving food scene. Mm-hmm. And so we have some awesome places on the list today, and I'm excited to get started with some breakfast and coffee because I am hungry. We just got to the first restaurant on our list, which is gonna be some authentic Mexican food. And they're open for breakfast, so we're gonna go have an awesome breakfast now. Okay, so our coffee came, and I got the name, it's Cafe de Olla. And it's sweet coffee, and it's really, really good.
So we got an order of chilaquiles, it's coming with mole poblano, and that's the darker mole. There's two different types. There's the poblano style and the verde style. We went with the poblano, more traditional.
I'm excited. Traditional chilaquiles.
Yeah, and then we're getting beans and cheese, and I think that we're getting a pear. She said con nopal, and Google Translate tells me that's some sort of prickly pear. I don't know, but I'm excited. I think it's going to be good.
It looks really good.
Yeah, we got some live music going on while we eat. But take a look at these.
Oh, yes.
Man.
I'm so excited to eat.
Let's dig in.
I just dropped some into my coffee. It was really good.
The mole sauce is, it's a little sweet. It's very rich. That's what I'm talking about.
Still good.
That breakfast was super good, but we got a lot more stops to hit today, so we're gonna get out of here and on to the next place.
That was such a good breakfast. That coffee changed my life. It was good.
I think there were some sort of oils or rinds or something in there to sweeten it up and make it a little more exotic tasting, but wow, was it good.
But enough about that place. This next place I'm even more excited about because it's a bunch of different little food stands. It's called Food Garden, and they have like all different kinds of foods. It's kind of communal seating, and it's just around the corner from where we were just at, and we're headed there now. So we just got to the Food Garden, and there's only a few places open right now. A lot of the booths are just shuttered closed, but it looks like there's a few good ones. It's crepes and chilaquiles, which we just had, so I'm thinking maybe some crepes sound good. This looks so good, and we got this pretty poker on a plate. Look at that bad boy. Ooh! Mm-hmm.
Alright.
That's so good.
My turn.
Mmm. It's a good crepe.
The cream cheese in the middle is really, really good.
It's warm. It's sweet. It's awesome.
My oh my. That crepe was super good. And I'd love to come back because we're walking by a little cornhole area and they've got string lights out, and I can see this being a really fun place to just hang out and spend an hour or two and have some food.
Definitely, especially when it's dark out, because I'm sure it gets busy for dinner and they have the string lights on the patio seating. And Tijuana's pretty hot in the summer, so it's definitely nice to eat outside.
So our next stop is a place called Los Arcos, which is known for its seafood.
Yum!
So I have a sneaking suspicion that a certain somebody's gonna be ordering a fish taco.
I love fish tacos.
And I'm still out on what I'll order, but I'm real excited. Some good seafood is always a nice addition to any food tour.
Especially in TJ. I mean, we're right on the water. You know it's gonna be fresh. Just got seated at Los Arcos. The restaurant is beautiful and it's definitely very nautical themed, which is to be expected when you're eating at a seafood restaurant. And we got seated and they really quickly brought us waters. And wait till you see this. This like fancy little thing. and it's got these like hard taco things and like some limes and peppers and salsa and salsa verde, and I'm upset that I'm talking right now because I just want to be eating it.
Okay, I'm looking at all these tacos and I'm excited because I see fish tacos, regular tacos, octopus tacos. If this machacha taco is what I think it is, then it's similar to what we had in Popotla, and that was so good.
So we just ordered. We got one taco for me, one taco for him, and then we also ordered a ceviche to split because that is supposed to be the really good thing to get here. Okay, we got our food and it looks good.
And check out this. We got a smoked fish taco.
Ooh, that looks good.
Ooh, yeah.
And then they also brought out our ceviche, which is kind of, it's hard to tip because there's a lot of liquids, which you can see there's a bunch of shrimp, there's avocado, there's cucumber, and a bunch of spices. And then to go with all of it, they also brought us out this cooked, baked, whatever, tortillas, and then some saladitas, which I assume are crackers.
And for anyone that is a complete rookie to ceviche, not that I'm an expert by any means, ceviche is just fish or some sort of seafood that has marinated in citrus juices, lime, orange, lemon, whatever. So it's raw, it's not cooked.
So if you don't like sushi, you probably won't like ceviche.
Correct.
All right, let's dig in.
Is it good? So where does this rank in the world of fish tacos?
Okay, first of all, it's shrimp. Sorry, I got confused. Second of all, best shrimp taco I've ever had. I'm at a loss for words. Just take my word and come to Los Arcos and order the shrimp taco. It'll blow your mind. I say we try the ceviche now.
Let's do it. I don't know if I've ever been properly instructed on how to eat ceviche.
I think you just put some on top, or do you break it first?
I'm gonna break it.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely like lime or lemon. It's citrusy. It's good. We're trapped in the rain. It just started pouring as soon as we left the seafood restaurant. And now we're under an awning to try and get away from it. But it's raining sideways. It's still coming at us. We still have one more place that we're going to eat at. But we heard about a really good ice cream place. So we're going to have ice cream first.
We're at Tempo's Nieves for some dessert. Let's go inside.
What did you get?
Okay, I got us the guanabana on the top, which is a type of fruit, and then on the bottom is horchata.
Ooh!
And this little guy was like 4 pesos, which is 30 cents.
Oh my gosh! That's amazing.
First bite is guanabana. It's good, it's really unique. Like, it's almost like a cross between an apple and a pear. You try it and let me know what you think.
Definitely, it's fruity, but it's not like anything I've ever had. Really good. That ice cream place was adorable. The entire inside is just colorful wood and it's carved and beautiful. And they have like 50 ice cream flavors or something insane in there. And would totally recommend going there because we got the tiny size and it was like 25 cents for US dollars. Our last food stop of the day is a little further away. So we're gonna hop in an Uber, and this is for our Vietnamese food stop because you know, there's more to Tijuana than just Mexican food. And since we got a good 3 Mexican restaurants in this morning, just kidding, 2, crepes do not count as Mexican food.
No.
Regardless, we got our fair share of Mexican food today, so we feel ready to try some pho in Tijuana.
Let's go.
Let's see if it's good. We are at our last, sadly, food stop of the day. but it looks really good. It's called Pequeño Saigon. We're gonna get some Vietnamese food, and it's this kind of like little hole in the wall place, and there's only a few tables. So we're gonna head in now and ask them what's good to order.
How good this looks. It is steaming, it is hot. I am so ready to dig in. It looks awesome.
So Tijuana has good Vietnamese food?
Tijuana has good Vietnamese food. You heard it here first.
Ooh, that's good. I just can't believe that this is the small size. I mean, it's like the whole bowl is like the size of my hand. And Jack is currently devouring it, but I'm like all full, but it's really good. Turns out Tijuana does have good pho.
Tijuana, the food here never disappoints. I always leave full, and I always leave happy.
Agreed, and I think it was fun today that normally we only have Mexican food when we come to Tijuana. Today we also have crepes, which is French fruit, and pho, which is Vietnamese. It just goes to show, it's a very international city. There's food for pretty much any international cuisine that you can imagine, and it's all more delicious than the next.
It's so true. The food here is incredible, and it just goes to show that this isn't a city of tacos. This is for everybody. Thank you for watching. Always appreciate it. Make sure to like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe. Goodbye.
Goodbye.